Okay guys, back on the painting now. I didn't like the original paint I put on. After a couple of days it just didn't look right, so now this is the new colour for the base. Now this paint is called Arctic Grey, which is just a light grey, and it's just an everyday paint you buy from the paint shop. I just brought a sample pot, and at this stage I don't mind the look of it, so this is after a couple of days too. That's the sample pot I used, British Paints. But that's the look so far of the base. But also, I've got to obviously add the other paints to bring it out. But I'm also going to ground cover as well. So I'm sort of going to ground cover and paint at the same time. Because if I paint, it means I'm going to paint, and then where I put my ground cover, I'm just going to cover it anyway, so it's a waste of time painting. So I thought I'd do both. So this will be a painting and ground cover series, if you want to put it that way. Okay guys, the first part I'm going to do is actually use my black wash just to darken up the rock and also the crevices. So what I would do is, as you can see, bring it out a bit. And this will dry a bit lighter, it won't be as dark. Now I'm using two black washes. One's will be more watered down than this one. I'll just keep going over it until I get the sort of colour I want. And if some places go too dark, I'll just use some more water. So all this rock work that I will be doing will be all by hand. And a lot of these Brocks also, I will be painting them sort of more black, like the wash, but it's going to be, as I said, it's going to be a lighter wash. So I'll just make the rock work a little bit darker than what it is. So I'll just finish doing all my black and then I'll show you the outcome. Now I'm going to just put the other black wash on, which is more water based than black. Now this will just darken the grey. Because there's more water in it, it shouldn't go as dark. Well, that's my aim. Just ever so slightly, as they say. I might have to darken up the darker ones, but I won't tell until it's dried. As you can see here how it's, I'm only making it light compared to where it's dark here. I just got to get rid of this light greyish look. So I will keep going on and finish this part of the scene and I'll show you what it looks like. Okay guys, that part's finished now. So as you can still see the dark crevices, but also the whole rock work's gone that little bit darker compared to this one that hasn't been touched. So at least you can sort of see the colour I'm going for. I'm also going to add some burnt umber just to give me some brown in the rocks. So the burnt umber will be the next part. Okay guys, now I'm going to use burnt umber over the whole rocks. Which will give it the brownie or browny look. But not too much, because because I will put this on and then sort of wipe it off just to give a, so I still get me grey coming through it. Which you should see when I actually do it. Because the backdrop mountains are actually between a grey to a brown look, depending on what the sun's actually shining on the rocks. So it's not totally grey when you look at it. And it should look a little bit better than just seeing grey rock. Well, in this case anyway. You can actually see at this stage how it's all bringing out different colours as well. And this is the burnt umber is actually from a tube, acrylic tube paint, like I did the very first time. So I'll go ahead and paint it all brown, because then the next part, when I put the more water on, you'll see the difference. Okay guys, now all the burnt umber's on. Now, we just put a whole heap of water just on the brush now, and sort of like you're washing it off. And then the sort of grey brown rock will face out. Well, that's the plan. Just so it's just not grey. But not to take it all off is the way to try and do it. And once it gets really wet, sometimes you just dry the brush on the towel, and as you can see, you take more off. sort of like dry brushing in a way. And then you get more than one looking rock, because you're getting all the different textures coming out in the rock. And at this stage there'll be no ground cover on this part. This is just going to be totally rock for this scene. As you can see, as I'm taking off the excess water, the colours are coming through. So I'll go ahead and finish it and I'll show you the outcome. Okay guys, now that's the finished product. All I've got to do now is carry on with the rest of the layout. But as I said, this will be no ground cover. And the rest will have it. So I thought I'd just show you how I'm painting my rock molds. And that's the look I'm getting.